Hello, everybody, and welcome to season 3 of the Weather News Happens Not Show. We've made it. It's 2024, ladies and gentlemen. As you can tell, we've got a new logo, the official Weather News Happens Not Show logo, might I add. We've got new lower thirds, as you can see them, as they are, they probably already have played by now. New music, new song for this season, and a new intro. So we're ready for season 3, and it is the beginning of the year, the first episode of season 3, but episode 42 of Weather News Happens Not Show in general. If you want to go check out the last episode that we did on here, we basically just recapped the entire year of 2023, and we talked about different ideas that we wanted to do. Dawson went down the list of a lot of the film ideas that we want to try to do in 2024, but we'll see. Get around to it, maybe. We're going to try to film a lot more films in general this year, and just a lot more videos in general this year than we did last year, because we did about 30 or so episodes of the show last year.
Yeah.
And we talked about all those in the last episode, if y'all want to go check that video out. Today, we haven't reacted to a film in quite some time. Probably since, I think the last time we reacted to a film was Star Wars The Stranger, I think so. And that was back in, like, September or something like that. I can't say that was the last time we reacted to something, because technically it was the Kamen Rider video. And we all know what happened with that one. But today we're going to be reacting to one of our films, a very recent film, actually, because it hasn't even been a year yet since we did this video. We actually talked about, in the little clip on our Instagram account, we talked about this film, is this exact film, and how we said we were going to react to it in the future, and here we are.
Here we are.
We're reacting to it, and we're going to talk about it today. If y'all have not seen our other reaction episodes, basically we'll be reacting to it first, right here, and then after, and we might stop at some, like we always do, but then we will go to the double cameras, the side-by-side shot, and we'll discuss some behind the scenes and talk about the making of this film. We're going to be reacting to Home, which is our second Western film that we've done, and the most popular Western film that we've done. It is also the channel trailer for this year. So y'all can easily just go on the channel, and it'll be right there, because, I mean, unless you're subscribed, then it won't be, but it'll be there. It's a really good film. Talk about your experience on doing Home really quick before I go into Who's Who.
I know we've only done two Westerns, but it's my favorite out of the two.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it. It's got...
I actually made a noise on here. Can't believe that. I made a noise on the mic.
I have tended to lean towards playing the broody characters.
Yeah.
And this one is that. I don't know. Home was one of those films that overall, it was just great.
Yeah.
Storyline was good. Acting was good. All of us did really good. Script wise came out good, because it brought it very intense moments. Videoing it was really good. Music was good, and just overall it was a good film, and it just wish it got more views. I don't remember how many
Home's got like 1,000. That's what I'm saying. It's got like, good. I don't think me and Dawson expected it to get 1,000. Revenge, the other one that we did, which y'all should go check out. Don't think we've reacted to that yet.
Mm-mm.
No, but we will in the future. Revenge, that one has probably half the amount of views as this one does. And it was funny that when we did this and then we saw that it's got like over 1,000 views now. It's wild. I think it's wild to both of us, because it was such a simple idea, and we didn't think, we thought it would just, you know, kind of like TikTok, which is another film that we'll react to in the future, but we thought that it would just be like that, like mm-hmm. that kind of film, where it's just, here it is, and blah, 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 and then it just blew up for some odd reason, and which is cool, it's great, yeah. you know. Technically, this is the second Civil War film we've done. Yeah. Because Dawson plays Jay Gurdon, who is a farmer and veteran of the Civil War. Yeah, you only get to see the Civil War in one scene, but the Civil War is mentioned. So
I break an arrow.
Yeah, he breaks an arrow in his arm, which is totally not sanitary whatsoever. Just leaving, yeah, you know. And but yeah, Dawson plays Jay Gurdon. Who is a farmer and veteran of the Civil War. I play Morris Tracy, who is a rich booty hole. Yeah, I'm not a great guy, but he is one of the rich guys from New York who wants to take Dawson's character's land.
How rude.
How rude. And then Ian is also in this one as Flynn Mortimer, the sheriff of the town that... Jay and Flynn himself live in, and I'm not gonna say what Flynn does, because, you know, it's in the film, spoilers. But Flynn has to figure out whether he wants to side with Jay or Morris.
Yep.
That's basically what it is, and it's a whole conflict of me trying to take Dawson's land, pretty much. And see, simple, it's a very simple idea, and we did this film back in August of last year in 2023, and I do remember it being very hot outside.
It was hot.
It was very hot outside. I remember that, because that was like towards the end of summertime. Mm-hmm. But it was still a lot of fun to do. Doing stuff like that, like Western films and crime films, are very easy to do. Well, it's very easy to do a film when you have a simple idea, obviously. Which, you know, we try to do a lot of the time. And with the Star Wars one that we did last year, that one was a simple idea, and that was fun to do. And then TikTok was very simple, and we did that one, and it was pretty good. I mean, pretty much all the ones we did last year were simple in their own way.
Mm-hmm.
I
want to do another Jasper McBride video.
And that one was also simple, too. Mm-hmm. The Hunter, a lot of people wouldn't think The Hunter would be a simple film, but the idea of it is... pretty simple.
Pretty simple.
He just is asked to go find a monster.
It was very, it was actually really simple, and it was kind of the same thing. It was just the way how we filmed it is the reason why it was so long.
Yeah, it just looks like we're everywhere all at once, and it's like, no, we it's really just were. Different. It's like big scenes all throughout, you know. But we'll probably react to The Hunter at some point in the future also. Yeah. But we're going to watch the Home, the film that we did, and we might, like we said, it's like a normal reaction video. We might pause to say some things. We might not. Yeah, we might not. Who knows? We might watch the, well, we're going to watch the whole thing in its entirety, but then we're going to talk about it. You know, y'all get to learn more about how it was made, how it was brought about, pretty much. But we're going to watch it. It's almost 30 minutes long. Which I think me and you were very surprised about.
Yeah.
There is a lot of talking in it, but it's to be expected, because it's, like we said in the last episode, movies are all about talking.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much. And we've kind of implemented that into a lot more of our films. There's a lot more talking.
Yep.
Because that's how movies are. A lot of people think it's all about action and stuff, but it's not.
It's not.
It's all about story and talking. But we're going to watch this, Home, a Western film from us, made by us, starring me, Dawson, and Ian. Here we go. Whether it'll pick it up or not, I don't know. It's okay. Oh, yeah, and this is also filmed at Dawson's house. All of it was filmed at Dawson's house. One of the few times that we've done that.
Mm-hmm.
looks so much darker. Oh, well, you filtered it, but it looks so much darker than I remember.
I'm actually surprised at how well the smoke did. And you can still see what's going on.
Yeah. You brought out the red on your the middle part.
Part of the arrow is still in
him. Yeah, in his back. That's why I was saying it's not sanitary.
No, not at all.
Home. We have a funny story about the title. We'll talk about that after this is over.
Home.
I've noticed that, too. We do, like, one-word titles now.
It's easier.
Hey, just think of a word, figure out the definition of that word, and then then you make a film idea out of it. Mm-hmm. It's not a bad idea. Just like retribution and revenge.
Retribution, home. Bounty.
Yeah. Yeah.
Leaf.
Yeah, random leaf. Hey, I shot all these, all right? I thought it would look great. Chain.
Me below
yeah,
it.
Yeah, pushing the chain. I think this is also the first film that Ian was in since Who Took Sarah. So, mm-hmm. like, a year. Almost a year. That's become a recurring thing.
Mm-hmm. You drunken?
He's drunk. I'm surprised I didn't break. I was expecting it to break. When in doubt, horse sound effects.
Mm-hmm.
When you can't afford a horse.
That's my eyeball. Yep. Now I've got
there
two.
There he is.
Wake up.
Mr. Jay Gurdon.
You should probably quit drinking.
Yeah, I don't think he cares.
Nope.
We also have filmed we took pictures at that shed for revenge. We didn't film at that shed for revenge.
We filmed inside of it.
The inside of it, yeah. But we've used the outside of it this time.
Mm. Look, there you are.
Yeah.
Mr. City Boy.
Well, Sheriff? Where is he?
Don't worry. He knows we're
good. Well, how do you know that?
So?
Smoking cigars.
Still breathing. I hear that for sure.
Mr. Gurdon, how do you do?
Well,
not talking to you.
Bye.
Why, the pleasure of you stopping by. Well, we were just gonna
Excuse me, sir, but I was talking to you.
That's funny, because I wasn't talking to you. Well, Jay, this is a man.
I'm just gonna ignore that didn't happen.
And he's gonna build up some more infrastructure and railroads in this town to make us, you know, have some money. Listen. Did I say something amusing to you?
Well, Mr. Gurdon, my name is Morris Tracy. I'm from New York.
Nobody cares.
Flynn. Why is the city boy here?
Me? Well, I'm here to buy up some land. And sometimes I take it. Well, you know, business is growing as usual. Well, like I said.
So you're a douche.
I buy up some land so we can put our railroads down and you're in our way.
Don't touch me.
Yeah.
Don't you ever touch me again.
No touchy. No touchy.
All right. Let's calm down. Jay.
It's not even that tense, man.
Like, this is helping the economy, man. This, and there's no really no repercussions. Nobody is bothering you. Like, let's come to an agreement.
No.
Well, there ain't nobody bothering me now.
Huh?
Listen, what? I'm just here to give you an offer.
You can take your offer back because it ain't for sale.
Excuse me?
It ain't for sale. Do I need to spell it for you? Now get off my land.
Listen, Mr. Gurdon. I've got the mayor and the sheriff on my payroll.
He's just like,
That's so.
That's so.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
Well,
you yellow-tailed piece of junk.
Well, I might have called you a lot of things in the past.
Like what?
Paid-off lawman, though.
Oh, my hand. Rated R version.
A coward, maybe.
That'd have been funny to be like, I'm just being nice.
Yeah. Crooked sheriff, that,
sounds about right.
Probably wasn't going to be one of them. Jay. Well, I've been known to be wrong before, but, I wonder what your dad would be doing. Probably turning around in his grave right now.
Jay, look, just try to
No.
Don't bring my dad into this.
Yeah. Sheriff Mortimer. You don't need to explain your actions to this man.
Say, Flynn. How much is it to pay off an old lawman to take innocent people's lands for this Mr. Morris here?
What? Sheriff Mortimer?
What? Why are you looking at me?
How much money I paid you to do this?
Mr. Jay, you gotta understand, man, I have a family. And it's
That's not the question.
Every piece of land that my lawman and the mayor helps with, I'm getting, we get 100. You have to understand, like, I'm trying to do this for my family.
Sounds lovely.
I'm just here to build the town up, put some railroads in, and watch the money come in.
Well,
that was pretty obvious, dude.
You just go and do that. Which okay. is not
I was thinking, what I probably would have said.
There's a lot of moments where your character could say
we
that.
We need him for the trading routes.
Well, that's a pity now, ain't it? This land you see? It's for my cattle.
All these trees?
Where? Where's the moo-moos?
Yeah, where's your animals?
Not you.
Who's your family?
So.
That's a good question.
These are
the questions that have not been answered.
Nobody. He does mention it
and
in a
I
minute,
mean,
I think.
Tells me no, Jay.
It says something about his sister going off and stuff. But
yeah, I think so. I know there's a part where you talk about it.
Flynn? I knew your father and your father knew my father. You know good as well I am by this. This is my home.
This is the part, yeah. This is it.
My father fought and bled for
this. We should have kept count of how many times we say home.
A lot. That's why I was saying, like, in the script, it's written in there a lot.
For a mom, a sister.
Even improvised, it's said.
You know, when I got back from the war, I came home to my dad dead.
Oh, wow.
My mom heartbroken.
And dead.
Her passing away.
Oh, yeah, and dead.
My sister married off.
And this she's dead. She's dead to me.
Now been left to me.
She's gone.
She's gone.
All of it. That corner of the trees. That corner of the pasture. Cattle.
Turn the camera around. House.
House.
It's mine.
Oh.
And I will fight for this property till I bleed or die. And nobody, not you, not the mayor, and not you, is gonna take you from me.
Jay, just listen, please.
Listen here, you cowboy people.
Whoa!
Jay!
That escalated. And the sheriff's got a big tattoo on his arm.
Jay?
Where'd you just pull that out of?
Poof! I got it.
So much details on that shirt.
Yeah. You're dead. You can see every hair follicle on your arm.
Yep.
Sheriff might get to me, but not before I turn your head into sunlight.
Oh, sunlight.
Mm. I'm gonna give you to the count of five.
And I'm gonna count to three.
Morris.
Adam.
Yes, Morris.
You might wanna drop this right now.
Fine.
Puts it back in my magical pouch. It's funny the music. It's funny the music just goes ding right when you do that.
Just
oh no!
Got him.
Credits roll. That'd be a funny meme. Just get that whole scene out there, and all you hear gun sound effect, and cuts black. All right,
Jay. It's
all right.
We're gonna leave now.
It's not okay. Pick off. Leave.
Yay. I'll be seeing you again really soon.
Nope.
That line kind of makes me think of the Into the Night, or One with the Night thing where I see that.
No, you ain't.
Well.
Just cuts.
I'll tell you this. You step one foot on my property again, I'll kill you where you stand.
Is that a threat?
That's a promise.
That when you first say that line, it looks like you look out to the side like, should I say it? And then should you say it.
I tip my hat to you.
Yeah. Basically, he's like, I've dealt with people like you before. Well, until later. Then you realize, no, you haven't.
No, you haven't. I'm dead.
Horses. Stock footage.
Stock footage. That would have been cool to film there, though.
Yeah.
It would have made it more realistic. We're trying to get better at filming in locations.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's hard, though.
Well, I guess that's enough.
Really?
I don't feel like putting up with it.
You listen here, Sheriff.
No.
I've got you and the mayor on my payroll.
You've already done
something.
Exactly
what I tell you to do.
I'm just telling him again.
Don't do this. You don't want to.
He looks like he wants to die. Like he's like, yes. Please do it.
I'm gonna die.
Sheriff, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna go back up there. We're gonna take this is his the plan. Land. I don't care what.
Here's the deal.
Here's
we're
the deal.
We're gonna take that land for our own.
Oh.
And if we Why have to, we'll kill him.
Well, that was so obvious.
You can cry, beg,
he's not
and
crying.
Plead for your life all you want, but I always get what I want.
Do you?
You've got a job to do, and we're gonna go back up there and
he sucks
take
at his job.
Yeah.
All right.
What do you want me to
Man,
do?
Man, you convinced him very easily.
What do you want me to do? I just told
Finally
you.
Finally, come to your senses. Now, if he tries to do anything to you, I don't care what it is. You kill him.
Alright.
That was good.
That's the face of, I know I'm gonna die.
I'm gonna die.
I'm gonna fail at this job.
I wrote this song.
Oh yeah, Dawson did this song, yeah. And the fact that no one's commented about
Right.
it at all.
I wrote this song and I played it, and here it is.
Well, nobody would have known that it was
this song. This never got copyrighted, did it? Because
well, no, it's your song. It shouldn't have. If it did, that'd have been. I mean, if we were monetized, it would probably be like, it sounds like this other song.
It's copyrighted. Whether the news happens or not, did this.
Yeah.
We are whether the news happens or not. Hey, I know you. Funny enough, there was actually supposed to be like a grave scene there, but we were running out of daytime and we didn't want to do any graves, so this is what we did.
Yeah, this is like the last thing we shot, I think. I think so. One of the last things we shot.
One of the last things. The last thing was the Civil War shot.
Yeah. It was like one of the last things with the sun out.
Yes.
I need some help.
I can't help you, they're dead.
We actually were gonna film this next to the river, but that didn't work.
That didn't work
at all.
So I wanted to buy and take this place.
You need a haircut. I need a haircut right now.
His character will get to that after this is over.
He doesn't get what he wants.
The Jay Gurdon series. He comes back with a haircut and no facial hair.
Fresh cut.
What happened to him?
What happened?
Well, I told you. Remember, I made you a promise whenever I got back from the war that I wouldn't put any more violence in this world. I also promised you and Pa that I'll protect this family and protect this home, protect this land, everything that I got.
I thought that was the bug for a second. What is the song?
Shut up. Well, I'm gonna keep that promise.
Which one? You said two.
There's a lot of promises.
I'm gonna protect our home.
Oh, okay.
Home number 3000. No. Power line that someone complained about.
Yeah, transmission lines. Mm-hmm. Hey, look, they got pistols.
You know the plan?
Nope.
What exactly?
Where did he go? Where did we go?
Didn't we film something and then, like, we didn't film it or something?
No, like, the actual clips is, like,
once again,
the... I was actually standing in front, and then in the next shot, I was behind you for some reason. Because I think I'm in that one shot, I moved around you, and then you quit recording. And I thought you got it on camera, but you didn't.
Hello. Hello, boys.
Time to die.
Time to die. Why do you keep looking at him?
It's the staring game.
Look back. Stop looking at me, you faggot.
Well, Mr. Gurdon?
That's me.
Have you thought about our little conversation?
Yep. F off.
I thought I told you that if you stepped one foot on my land again, I'd show you where you stand.
You did say that.
Well, I'll take that as a no then.
Ah, you're smart.
Yeah.
It definitely wasn't a yes.
Ah. Clarification.
You're not gonna be smiling and laughing and making dumb comments like that when you got bullet holes.
I love how he just turns on you so quickly.
How exactly
you're gonna die.
Did you really think you're gonna get out of this one?
I don't even know how to properly tie a tie.
By walking.
Yeah.
You ain't gonna have. I'll fight for this land till the day I die.
That was whenever he said, "Well, we can make that happen."
You're gonna do that.
All it takes is one bullet.
Well, quite frankly, Mr. Gurdon.
Quite frankly, you're too close to my face. You can see my pores.
Try me.
I'm like, oh.
Oh no. I love the song that goes with the scene.
Yeah.
It's so like, oh god, what is about to happen? I think it's the violins that just like,
yeah.
I want your land right now.
Oh!
He's a warrior.
Man, these guys are from the Matrix. They're dodging bullets.
Where are you running to?
The fact that this took like 30 minutes to an hour to film and it was like 5 seconds was the wild part.
Another cool thing, speaking of this scene, to make it more realistic, we actually counted every single shot that we did to make it line up with the guns that we have.
Yeah.
I don't have any more bullets. I'm not a threat to you anymore.
No, you're still a threat. You can die.
It's funny because it's almost like he plays like three different characters in this film. Like the character at the beginning, then the character right before he gets shot, and then this one.
looks of it, they'd probably be better off without you.
Ooh, diss.
Wait, you don't have harsh. To do this.
Yeah. I do.
Oh, he gone, son.
Woo!
He gone.
I love this shot right here. Just the silhouette. It looks so cool.
Yeah.
Well, now he's a dead one. So.
Yeah. I also had to remember to not move my left arm at all.
Next film, Mr. Gurren is the new sheriff.
Yeah. That would make sense. He wouldn't be able to get himself arrested.
Got him.
Not my liver. Not my kidney. Where did you come from?
He spawned.
He just spawned in. Ultra slow motion.
That death stare, just, I'm going to murder you.
Yeah, he's got a mission. He's on a mission.
I give zero craps. You're gonna die. Ah, you nicked me in the neck, eh? Owie.
He's like, oh, well, crap, you know.
Ah. Dang. Got him.
Shot him in the same spot. It was actually pretty comfortable laying there, except all I could feel was bugs.
I remember you saying that. You were like, I'm actually comfortable.
Yeah, right, I was like, take y'all's time.
Yeah.
I'm just chilling.
Pick it up.
No. That was a struggle. I remember that. Uh-huh. Begging's for wimps.
This is my home. And you came here to destroy. This is not yours.
You didn't come to destroy my home. You came to destroy home, the film.
This is mine.
I'm sorry. I'll leave.
My crotch. It's because he was so far away.
I said I'll leave. I won't come back.
No. I don't want you to leave.
What?
What? So I can stay?
What do you mean? No, I'm a man of my word.
And the sun went down. Looks like it got dark.
You wanted land?
You don't have to go!
And everyone's dead except for Jay.
Yep.
There's like the symbol of Jay, the barbed wire crown.
I will say this ending with the music is on my top list of endings.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but it's just cool. And there's nothing to it. It's just me grabbing and
just
my and bottle again.
Basically full circle. You're just going back to what you're doing.
Nothing happened to
you. Yeah, like this is just a normal occurrence for me.
And it's there I read on a hillside gravestone. You'll never be far alive.
Nice. That was it. Boom.
That was it.
I haven't watched that in a while.
I haven't either, actually. Awesome balls.
Jay Gurren. Yeah. Gurdon's probably the most unique last name I think I've ever used for something.
Morris Tracy.
Ian. And then Dawson's song.
My song again. Boom.
This is one of the very few films that have been written. Dawson wrote this.
I did.
Yeah.
I'm trying to write more scripts. Another thing is, if you're wondering, the reason why there's been, like, there's long parts in the song like that is there actually was supposed to be lyrics to it.
Yeah.
I just never got around to it.
And then that didn't happen.
That never happened, so.
But that was Home. Us reacting to Home. Like we said, we haven't watched it in a while. But it came out 4 months ago, which is wild. 1,200 views on the Home film. We have a couple of comments on this video as well. I've replied to a couple of them. The one comment said, "Bro, this is so cool. Smart acting, amazing storyline. You're natural, my brother. Keep him coming." And then I thank the guy.
Thank you.
So that was Andy Plays Roblox on YouTube.
Mm.
We also got critical comments, as you know, if you post stuff on YouTube, you're bound to get some. From Andrew12759, we had nice effort. Watch out for the visible anachronisms when making a period era film, and there are a lot of quote unquote treetop shots. And then I replied to that one as well. It's kind of hard to physically move power lines.
Yeah.
From a shot.
I work for the power company.
Yeah.
You can't do that.
It's kind of hard to do that, and it's also hard with the amount of money that we don't have to try to do something like this. Somebody else commented, a Thomas Taylor 6355 said, Railroad Tycoons did this S-word. You own the railroad, you control the money, and vice versa. Exactly. So a little historical acknowledgement there. Right. That was us reacting to Home. We had a couple of comments there. But to get an exact number, we've had 1,236 views, 5 comments, and 17 likes on that film. Mm-hmm. And it was the most popular film that we did of 2023.
We had comments about the film and the behind the scenes too.
Yeah, I forgot about that. Let me see what we might react to the behind the scenes of Home as well, and also we might react to the other behind the scenes of films that we've done, such as Star Wars Bounty, Star Wars The Stranger, Brothers as well. Because we already reacted to Ghost, the behind-the-scenes of Ghost. Mm-hmm. Somebody commented on the behind-the-scenes, Haley Brown 5333. Awesome. Love the movie. Great. I'm glad you liked it. And then Raj-OT1HW commented an idea, gave us an idea for a Western film,
mm-hmm.
Where it is a man named Dan Boy against 3 bounty hunters, basically. And if y'all want to go read that entire word-for-word idea, it's in the comments of the behind-the-scenes. It's probably one of the longest comments I think that we've ever gotten on here, I think. Yeah. Unlike the essays of comments that we've gotten on other videos.
Yeah.
But yeah, that was that. We'll now we're gonna go into the section where we're gonna talk about how we came up with the idea for this film, everything leading up to it, and then filming it as well. You get some little tidbits of that, talking about how we came up with the title, how we came up with the characters, how Dawson began writing the film, and how long it took to get this film started and filmed, basically, since Revenge, because that was the last one that we did. Let's start to that.
Dude, yes. I need that to freaking, like, smell right before work.
There you go.
Like, it just... Who's ready to go to work? Who's ready to change out some Transformers? Let's go!
Yeah! Whether it's safe
or
not.
Oh, hey, everybody.
Okay, so we're here in the split screen zone. I called it that the last time.
The split screen
zone. Calling it the split screen zone now.
The zone or the split screen?
Both. The split screen zone.
Split screen zone.
So, yeah, we just got done watching Home, our Western film, Home. And we're going to talk about now how many ideas we came up with beforehand and how long it took to get to where we made the Home the film, and also how it basically all came together, writing, editing, everything-wise.
Mm-hmm.
I was telling Dawson off-camera that this film was four or five years in the making, because we had a lot of Western ideas that we may or may not go through in this episode. But it was all leading up to this film, Home. And the title, hilariously enough, we did not have a title for this film at all until Dawson sent me the script. And I noticed the amount of times home was in it, because Dawson wrote the word home a lot in the lines. And so I told Dawson I thought it would be pretty easy to give it a title and just call it Home, because it's calling home.
Of his show.
Oh, yeah. Ian just sent him a... taking a Snapchat really quick. That was from Ian. It was, his home was in the script a lot. And so I just told Dawson, I was like, why don't we just title it that? So, you know. So we did. How did you come up with this idea? Because Dawson wrote the script to this film.
A lot of different things kind of come together. Actually, prominent thing that made me do it is there is a Western that is called and that just left my mind.
Insert Western here.
Open Range.
Oh.
Great film. Awesome. Like, it's a that's also where the whole thing of, like, stealing things, that's based off of, like, cattle. Not so much land, but, like, livestock.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing with the End Shootout. I actually got some parts from the cartoon Western Rango that has Johnny Depp in it.
That's funny.
I also got some parts from Tombstone.
Mm.
I mean, there's a couple of different things that kind of blended together, and then there's just some things that just kind of came at the top of my head that just was like, this would work right here.
Yeah,
that makes sense. Character wise, while I was writing it, Mr. Gurdon, of course, he's like this brooding character that just wants to be left alone, which is reasonable because he just went through the Civil War. His dad and his mom are both dead. His sister's married off, and he's just kind of there.
She's technically dead then.
Yeah, so he's just kind of there, and he's just trying to protect the land. The sheriff was kind of an iffy character. I remember when I first started writing it, I made the sheriff be kind of a jerk, like, right off the bat.
Yeah.
And then when I rewrote it and started working on it again, I made it to where he was, like, a, like, in-between kind of character.
I do remember in the original one, there was me and another guy. Yes. And we had another character. I was supposed to have, like, a little sidekick. Mm-hmm. And he was going to be, like, the first one killed, but... Yep. We like didn't.
Right off the bat.
Yeah, but we didn't do that because we only could get Ian, so. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, there was that guy, and it just kind of went on with it, and he was supposed to be a jerk as well. And then your character, obviously, it was just like...
Was the antagonist.
Is the antagonist. So I wrote his character out to be, when you're watching it, you automatically hate him.
Yeah.
Because you're like, you, of course, you don't want to like the antagonist. That's one big problem with nowadays, is like when they, like with superhero films especially.
Yeah.
They make it now to where like the antagonist is like, oh, you want to feel for them. No, they're the bad guy.
Yeah. Not unless you're going to turn them good at the end.
Yeah, unless you get like an actual storyline for them. But no, if they are the bad guy, you want to hate them.
Yeah.
That's the whole purpose of it. So when I wrote it out, I got to the script where I was like, well, it's either we buy up land or we take it. And right off the bat, you're like, oh, this is not a good person. And it kept on going through and going through.
Wow.
And then I wrote out the ending where your character gets shot and then it goes in. But, yeah, that was kind of the whole layout of writing the script.
Yeah, I gave Dawson the names for all the characters, mm-hmm. Which that's kind of the usual format if we talk more about our films and writing them, because I think this is one of the only, I think it's the first one that we've talked about that you wrote.
Yeah.
Ghost was written, but that was, I put that Dawson wrote it because it was another idea that we, but it was the White Ghost and had nothing to do with Black Panther. Mm-hmm. But we used none of that script. We just used the idea of it. So that's why I put writer, because it was written. But now usually that's the process of how it goes, is Dawson writes the scripts normally, or me and him come up with ideas, Caitlin too, and Dawson writes them, and then I give the characters names. And it's been going like that for almost a decade now. So,
yeah.
But that'll be a more prominent thing when we talk about more of the stuff that we've written or come up with. But yeah, Jay, I literally got all their names from a Western name generator.
Yeah.
Fun fact. And it just worked. Gurdon, I did not know was a Western last name.
Gurdon.
And when you picked that name, because me and Dawson always pick our names, we pick, if it's anyone else, like Ian or whoever, we've learned our lesson. We'll talk about that in a future video. We learned our lesson to just pick their names without them picking them. And me and Dawson, so I gave Dawson a list, and he picked that one, and I was surprised, because, like, Gurdon does not sound like a Western name, but hey, whatever works, you know. But, yeah, it took us about 4 or 5 years. We had about 2 or 3 ideas that I can think of off the top of my head that we had before we got to this one. But a lot of stuff happened, that fell through with those, like the one, the Red Dead 2 campfire one, the one where we're actually going to film in that Western town, but that didn't happen. And then, me and you were, brothers, was that right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, either that or it was you and Preston were brothers and one of them gets killed, or, and then Caitlin and Alyssa were supposed to play, like, the husband or the wives,
husbands.
That's 2024 guys. Wives of the brothers, and that one was just like a one-worded title too.
Yeah,
I think. And then there was another one that I thought of just now where it was you play that Rico guy. I forgot what his last name is. I have some of these ideas on my phone because I. We try to keep up with a lot of them in case we want to, like, do them.
Johnny Ringo.
Return of the Gun. Rico Sharp. It's the one where your brother gets killed, and I play the mayor with a bunch of thugs.
Oh.
I haven't touched that one since 2019, so... But yeah, there's a lot of them, including that one that we were wanting to do for a while because we thought Revenge did so well. So we're like, oh, we should do another one. And then it took us 3 or 4 years, and then we did Home. Vengeance. Huh? Oh, Vengeance, yeah. Vengeance. Sounds almost similar to Revenge. But hey, like we said when we were reacting to the video, we might try that where we take a word, figure out the meaning of the word, and then make a film out of it. We've done that before with Halo Remembrance, where we used the word remembrance, and funny enough, it was just a word that I thought of, and then we looked up the definition on the last day of filming, and it fit very well. Right. And so we just went with it. Revenge is the same way. Retribution. That was a weird moment too, because I remember we didn't have a title the whole time we filmed that one. We'll probably talk about. Well, obviously, we'll react to that one and talk about it.
When we react to that one, we need to react to all three.
The series? Yeah. We'll have to do that for Red Hood, too.
Yeah.
But when we react to the Arrow series, we'll talk about more into the Arrow series with that one and how, like, we connected and stuff. But, yeah, it was weird because we were sitting there upstairs late at night, and I remember we looked up, like, the first word that I thought of was retribution. Because it made me think of revenge because I was like, okay, well, you know, Retribution sounds like a cool title, and then I looked it up, and it was exactly the story. And we didn't even, like, plan it or anything. It was just what it was. But, yeah, we filmed this in one day, all at Dawson's house. And Ian was in it, obviously, playing the sheriff that gets killed. I think it was one of the first times he gets killed on camera. I think. That I can remember. Because he's been killed off camera in Chase, and you kill him off camera in Journey to the Past. You've killed him off camera a lot.
Yeah, that's right.
And I think this was the first time he actually got killed on camera, and you see it. And that took all of 4 years to get to that moment. But
it was a heck of a moment too.
It was a heck of a moment. Yeah. Getting shot square in the head. It's funny too, because in Revenge we have a similar scene, except it wasn't done as good as that one, but still I got shot in the head.
I know this is how, you know, we actually filmed it good.
Yeah.
And we had everything laid out nicely too. Is that scene came up and Caitlin was watching it and she was just like, oh, okay. And then it was just like, yeah, I do, and then I shoot him in the head. Mm-hmm. She was like, I was not expecting that.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, it gets all quiet. You don't expect it to happen.
And it was like one of those things, is that's why I wrote it out too, because it was just like, you don't have to do this, and you hear him say, yeah. And it's like, oh, so he's not going to shoot him, and he's just like,
no,
I do. Bam!
I'm going to trick you. Now, it's funny, though. It's weird, because, like, we make the film and like the scene like that, and we know what's going to happen, but then when other people react like she did, it's kind of a weird feeling. Yeah. It's like, oh, other people didn't expect it, because we expect it.
We knew it was going to happen. Which, like, it's so cool getting other people's reactions with stuff too, because you see their reaction to what we made, to the fact of like, we were like, okay, this is supposed to be like a surprising scene. And then it actually surprised people.
Yeah.
So it's like, oh, so we did our job. We did it good. So.
Yeah. There's just like when we react to Who Took Sarah, which will be a really long episode. but when we do, the reaction to that film was really funny too. And we'll talk about that when we watch it at some point when we have an hour. But yeah, it took us about 4 or 5 years to get to the filming of it. And then we filmed it. And that, like I said, it took all day, and we edited it. We took a week off. That's why there was not an episode the week after we filmed it, because we were working on the film, and it took all night, I remember.
Yep.
And it came out at the end of August, and now it's got like over 1,000 views. Crazy stuff. Yeah, craziness. Yeah, it's funny because some of those... I remember when I watched that film, I remember some of the stuff that Ian and like you or have been in other films, like the hat that Ian wears is Johan's hat in Highlanders.
Mm-hmm.
It's also my hat in Revenge as well. So there's a lot of different props and stuff that get used multiple times.
Multiple times.
I don't think anything that you wore did.
Mm-mm.
No. And then none of mine, obviously, because you bought that.
Yeah.
So mine was completely new. But yeah, Ian had that hat that we've wore like several times in films of the past. But yeah, we spent a pretty good while on the film in general. And it was a lot of fun to film. I will say I would rather film a Western in the fall because of the fact of when I was on the ground, like the amount of bugs that were out there.
Oh, yeah.
And just how hot it was. And I now know not to wear all black when the sun is out. Because I was sweating not as bad as Chase. That was worse. But
yeah.
But yeah, I'm not going to ever do that again. But yeah, that. The shed was the same shed that we used in Revenge and The Legend. We used it in The Legend as well. But we just used the outside of it, so it was a little bit different this time. I said earlier that this is technically the second Civil War movie. Who knows? Maybe Jay and Thomas have crossed paths. Connections, brothers and home.
Maybe.
Because he was a Confederate soldier, right? Or the Union soldier? Jay.
Jay is a Union soldier.
Okay, at some point, they probably fought each other, and they didn't even know it.
Oh.
There you go. And I was, my character in Brothers was on his side. So we probably were buds.
Maybe.
Who knows? But, yeah, it's a little connection there. But yeah, it was a really cool film to do. Final thoughts on Home?
I was going to ask you.
Ask me. Ask away.
Ask away.
Ask away.
How did you like playing that character?
I was glad that I didn't have to put like an accent on because we used to do films, I'd get excited about doing accents. And then ever since we did Yin and Yang, I hate doing them. Like Yin and Yang, we'll watch that at some point in the future.
Such a good film.
Like we say about all of our stuff, we're going to watch all of our stuff in the future, obviously, because we've made so much stuff in the last decade. But, and I mean everything. We'll go way back. We talked about that.
Yeah.
I was basically playing, I say this about a lot of the villains that or antagonists, I need to quit calling them villains because they're not like super, we used to call them that and heroes, but they're antagonists and protagonists. All the antagonists that I do play is like me, but evil.
Yeah.
I mean, that one wasn't very hard because for a person that lives in Georgia and doesn't have a Southern accent that much, it's not that hard for me to play a person like that.
Yeah.
Yes, it did come out in some parts. I noticed it when we watched it back, but it doesn't really matter.
No.
But it was fun. I really love playing. I think I've always loved like playing not just characters, but doing films where there's a lot of talking because you really get to see not just my acting, but everyone else's acting when you have a lot of talking parts. My favorite part, talking-wise, was probably the scene where I'm, like, mouthing off Ian behind your house.
Oh, yeah.
Because the way that... I will say this, Dawson did write the script, but most of it was improvised because we took the lines from the script and we improvised the lines, really. So, because we're not professionally trained actors, you know. And if we were, we probably still would improvise. Who knows? But the long, kind of like Star Wars Bounty, where I had that whole long speech to you, that's like one of my favorite ones in any Star Wars that we've done, where I just go off on you. Same thing with Ian, and I just like, you know, I tried to play the character the way that you wrote it, where he's like sadistic the entire time.
Mm-hmm.
Like where he's like, oh, I only care about myself and I only care about money, and so I took that into consideration and ran with it. It's just me. A lot of people it's weird because I play characters that I am the exact opposite of.
Yep.
In real life, so it's weird because a lot of people don't be like, "Oh, you don't seem like an evil person."
Yeah.
But then I'm an evil person in this one.
Ta-da.
But it was fun playing that one. What about you playing Jay? Was it typical for you, or because Glenn and Jay are kind of similar?
Glenn and Jay are kind of similar. I will say Jay is a little bit more brooding.
Well, yeah,
he's a lot more just like, "I'm killing you."
Well,
right now.
You gotta understand, Glenn killed more people than Jay did.
I will say when I played Jay, which I know we were younger, so and it was like one of those things that playing Glenn was. Because, like I said, we were younger, so we were just first getting into, not really first, but we were really getting into this
seniors
stuff.
In high school.
Yeah. So. Point.
Yeah, we were seniors in high school. That's weird.
And we did it, and we thought it was awesome, which it still is. It's a really good film.
Yeah.
Didn't really think very much into the acting aspect of it, because we always did the same thing. We would always act the way we acted. We always kind of did the same thing. With this is why I made the comment about it earlier. Watching videos and like seeing how people do stuff kind of helped out. And like what I say is Jay, he's a lot more brooding and a lot more just like
he's got a darker. Well, not I shouldn't say darker backstory because your whole family died. Yeah. So
my biggest thing, and like I said, I say a comment about it at one point is. Eyes is the whole on the audience perspective, you gotta be able to fool the audience.
Yeah.
So it's like one of those things, it's like you gotta how do you look? And it's like that scene where you're like slow mo shot. In that scene you can see and it truly looks like he's going to murder him.
Yeah.
And he gives zero craps about anything
he's
else.
He's not he's not in the present at this
point. No, like all he cares about is shooting you in the face.
And he's killing this guy, yeah.
And that's what it comes across, and that's the ordeal. So it was. So I wouldn't say typical because it was kind of different.
Well,
just
mean like with the archetype of characters that. You played
I know I tend to play angry people a lot.
Yeah.
And it was one of those things that like me and you always it's like this weird like arc that we've had ever since when we started filming. It's always been you liked playing the villain, I've played the hero-esque character. Here's a film.
Yeah.
And it works.
And there's other, always other ideas that we've done where it's not always Dawson in that position and I'm in that position. And in high school, that was like the typical thing. I always liked playing the bad guys. And I like playing anything, really, anymore. I mean, acting is acting. It's just, you know, as long as you like the character and you want to do it because most actors that's why they get into it but yeah like you said like most of the films earlier when we did them the acting in those is like we're acting like Dawson and Trace not Jason Todd or
no we're not acting like the characters
was our version of acting what we thought was acting.
I will say once we got more into it just this one is a great example of that is like how you actually said that great is back then it was just like we were acting as ourselves playing these characters and that's how it was
what we thought was acting
now we completely submerge ourselves in these characters of like we've got to be able to fool people that this is who we are and in this film, we actually did that pretty good.
A big example, and we'll have a longer conversation about it, is Who Took Sarah was the one that I think convinced so many people, not just me, but everybody, like, of we are these characters. We're not Dawson and Trace. Yeah. Like that, we were completely two different people in that entire thing. And that, and like, I think we didn't start really going into like, in like in depth, probably better acting until probably when we did when COVID started.
Yeah.
Because when we did Star Wars Aftermath, and that was the that's why that one's like my, and we'll watch that obviously, but. That's why that one, I think, is so much my favorite, because when I watch it, I don't see it as me and him, me and Dawson in the video. It's Dash and Owen in the video. And
I've gotten to the part, I've actually gotten to the point. Now, I know some people, like, I know they've said it before, like our parents, and sometimes it's weird to them that they just see it's like, oh, it's Dawson and Trace, and they're just kind of like, yada, yada, yada about it. But, like, It has gotten to the point where, like, while I'm watching it, or Caitlin's even said this to, like, whenever she's watching it or whatnot, watching it for the actual story and the characters. Don't watch it knowing that it's like, oh, that's Dawson and Trace.
Yeah.
Like, we're friends with them or yada, yada, yada.
But that's a lot of people's problems. They don't take it serious, I guess.
Yeah, they don't take it as like, oh, this is a film to watch. They think of it as like, oh, that's Dawson and Trace, the yada, yada, yada. So we have gotten better with the whole immersing ourselves with the characters.
I think also when we did films a lot in high school with like Red Hood and characters that we didn't even come up with, they're just like already done, like Joker and all them. It made it to where we just acted like ourselves. We didn't, because we knew how the characters were. We just acted like us dressed up as these people. Mm-hmm. Well, unless it's Horrors of the Past, it's a little bit different. But I mean, like, prior to that one, that actually, I take that back. That was probably the one where we, like, really got into acting, was that one. Like, not into acting, but really into, like, the character, I guess. But, like, doing films like Home and The Hunter and stuff that's not Superman, Batman, Iron Man, Spider-Man, anything with a man in it. It makes it easier. To me, I think it makes it easier because you're not having to be like, oh, how does this person actually act? And it's an actual person.
Yeah.
Like, or something like that. Kind of like playing Nelson Mandela or something. Mm-hmm. Like playing a real person. But yeah. That was Home. Reacted to that, talked about that. I don't think there's anything else that we, behind the scenes, that we need to mention. Caitlin was not a part of this.
No, she helped out for a second.
She did help out a little bit, but
she did the smoke.
She was the smoke lady. But yeah, she was not really in the film, not a part of the film, because she is, some of the films that we've done, she's wanted to just be a fan of it and then just watch it, you know, and which I totally get that. But so that's another little tidbit. She wasn't a part of the making of it. It was just me, Ian, and Dawson. But that was us talking about Home, everything leading up to Home. If you want to go watch it again, it is the channel trailer on this channel. If you aren't subscribed, you'll see it as the channel trailer, but if you are not subscribed, or if you are, well, if you are subscribed, you'll see our last video, this one. But if you are not subscribed, you will see Home, and you can go watch it, and it is great. Or you can go back and watch us react to it again, whatever you want to do. Anything you want to say before we say goodbye?
I don't think nothing off the top. Look out for next week's episode.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Next week's episode is going to be a doozy. I'll say that for sure. I'm not looking forward to it.
I am. This is going to be
Dawson
fun.
Is. I'm a little bit afraid of what's going to happen. So, yeah, y'all get to find that out next week. So stick around for that. Subscribe. Do all that cool stuff. Leave a like on the video if you like this episode of the show. If you want us to react to more of our stuff, our older stuff, our newer films, whatever video that we've done on the channel that you want us to react to, let us know, or any video to react to in general, because, you know, other things get us hate, so, you know, let us react to that, and we'll see what happens. So we talked about in the last episode watching like shows and movies and doing episodes of us watching it and reacting to it and talking about it afterwards. But comment down below what TV shows, what movies, whatever you want us to watch, and we'll get around to doing it. And subscribe to the Weather News Hammersonaut channel. The most important thing to do, hit the notification bell so you can be notified when more episodes of the show, more videos come out on the Weather News Hammersonaut channel. My name is Trey Sparks.
My name is Dawson Mullins.
We'll see you guys in the next episode of the Weather News Hammersonaut show, season 3. Bye-bye.
Bye.